Hello everyone, in today's video I'm going to discuss how to write a good film review. You have recently watched an interesting film, write a review of this film in about 200 to 250 words based on the points given below. And we will have to elaborate, we will have to develop our review using these points. Name of the film and its director, actors in the film, type of the film, plot, quality of direction, acting, cinematography, costumes, sets, reaction of audiences, recommended or not recommended. You may add one or two points of your own and you will have a well-written film review. Now, as a reviewer, your goal is to attract the reader's attention. In this case, it is specifically the examiner's attention, and to convince viewers to go or not to go and see the film. The review needs to be an unbiased outlook of the reviewer. Top tips for writing film review. Use vocabulary specifically related to films. Say what happens in the film, but do not give away the ending. Be careful, spoiler alerts. Don't give out the spoilers. Talk about different aspects of the film. Use a variety of adjectives and descriptive phrases. Finish by saying whether you would recommend the film or not and why. Type of film or genre: comedy, romance, love story, animated film, mystery, action film, science fiction, biography, thriller, detective. Watch any film of your choice and write a review of the film. Let's read the film review and then we will analyze how to write a film review. Film review: Spider-Man No Way Home, the most recent installment of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Spider-Man No Way Home has been received with excellent reviews, some understandable criticism, and a lot of fan excitement. Directed by John Watt, this movie, which released on 16 December 2021, may be credited for redefining the modern superhero genre with brilliantly mingled elements of fantasy, adventure, action, and science fiction. Tom Holland, Spider-Man, Zendaya, MJ, Jacob Batalon, Ned Leeds take us on a funny, exciting trip, superbly supported by Benedict Cumberland, Doctor Strange. Moviegoers are thrilled as Peter Parker, played by Tom, is joined by Tobey Maguire's and Andrew Garfield's versions and their respective monstrous villains. This twist, although expected from trailers, speculations, offers visual extravaganza and thrice more fun, making the film the first pandemic-era movie to cross $1 billion at the global box office. And then the next paragraph. With Spider-Man's identity now revealed, Peter asks Doctor Strange for help. When the latter's spell goes wrong, Dr. Octopus, Green Goblin, and a few others from the multiverse appear. Peter sets out to resolve the conflict, which creates tension, resulting in Aunt May's death. The bittersweet ending has victory coming at a cost that is almost too much to bear. Beyond its humor and nostalgia, there is a message that values redemption over revenge, reconciliation over rivalry. Themes of love, friendship enrich the plot. The action scenes are riveting, cinematography, special effects, background music equally mind-blowing. Everyone has done a phenomenal job. However, Doctor Strange perhaps jumps into an incredibly dangerous spell without explaining the full consequences. Peter, too, could have been more careful before approaching Doctor Strange. destroying the time-space continuum for anything that is not a world-ending threat is not an option he should have considered at all. J. Jonah Jameson, who always prioritizes hatred for Spider-Man, is ludicrous. The timeline of events is incredibly short. The film, especially 3D screenings, is highly recommended and must be watched on the big screen because of its grandeur. An analysis of how to write a film review. Film review, Spider-Man, No Way Home, leave online and write the date. I have written 8 January 2022. If your examination is in the month of March or April, choose accordingly. And then in the next line, write down the name of the reviewer. I have written a fictitious name, Arimita Sen, and then I have again left a line and I have started the introduction from the next line. This is the introduction. The most recent installment of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Spider-Man No Way Home, has been received with excellent reviews, some understandable criticism, and a lot of fan excitement. Remember, in the question paper, they had asked you to write about the audience's reaction. So, these two words, fan excitement, sum up the reaction of the audience. So just two words, and I have mentioned about the reaction of the audience. The name of the film has to, the title of the film has to be mentioned clearly. Spider-Man No Way Home. And any film receives good reviews as well as negative reviews. In this case also, the film Spider-Man has received excellent reviews, criticism, and a lot of fan excitement. So, see how I am writing the film review using words, expressions, and phrases specifically related to films. For example, reviews specifically related to films, and then criticism, another term specifically related to film, fan. Yes, we associate the word fan with films. So in this way, try to develop on the points given in the question. Name of the director. Directed by John Watt. This movie, which released on 16 December 2021, the release date, may be credited for redefining the modern superhero genre with brilliantly mingled elements of fantasy. It is a make-believe world, fantasy, adventure, action, and science fiction. There is time travel, and then the time-space continuum, the reference to multiverse. So, this film has an element of science fiction. The genre, the type of the film. Tom Holland, Spider-Man, Zendaya, MJ, Jacob, Ned Leeds take us on a funny, exciting trip. Superbly. Use of adjectives or descriptive phrases. Superbly supported. A term specifically related to films. The supporting cast by Benedict Cumberland, Doctor Strange. So what do I have in the very first paragraph? The film title, the genre, the director, the main performers. Clearly mentioned in the first paragraph. And what do you need to do? In order to write a film review, you need a little bit of previous knowledge. Now, when you will watch a film, or if you have chosen a film, try to jot down the points, the relevant points, so that you can prepare a little beforehand. So if you're planning to write a film review on the spot, you will be in a fix. So you will have to prepare a little beforehand. A little bit of previous knowledge is needed. The title of the film must be clearly written, correctly written. The director's name, the name of the producer, if you want to mention that, the cast, the crew, the genre, and the release date. So a little bit of previous knowledge is all you need in order to start your film review. Moviegoers are thrilled as Peter Parker, the protagonist of the film, Peter Parker, Spider-Man, played by Tom, is joined by Tobey Maguire's and Andrew Garfield's versions and their respective monstrous villains. Now, many of you may say, ma'am, spoiler alert, why did you mention this? Well, this twist, although expected from trailers, speculations, offers visual extravaganza and thrice more fun. My justification is that this is now, after the release of the film, a well-known secret. So there is no harm if you mention this spoiler, if you give out this spoiler. If you don't want, don't do it, don't reveal it. I have not revealed anything about the ending though. I have kept it a secret. Making the film the first pandemic era movie to cross $1 billion at the global box office. See how I have related the film review to the present context. This contextualization will help you to fetch more marks. The next paragraph, the plot or the summary in brief. With Spider-Man's identity now revealed, Peter asks Doctor Strange for help. When the latter's spell goes wrong, Dr. Octopus, Green Goblin, and a few others from the multiverse appear. A key element in the film, multiverse, and the appearance of the villains. I have mentioned the names deliberately, mentioned the names of only two villains. I know all the names of the other villains as well, but let the readers feel curious as to know who they are. Let the examiner feel excited as to know who they are. So in this way, try to attract everyone while writing the film review. Peter sets out to resolve the conflict which creates tension resulting in Aunt May's death. A major turning point in the film. The bittersweet ending. So, look at this adjective. What kind of ending? A bittersweet ending. Without revealing anything about the ending, I have attracted the readers towards this word. Bittersweet. The bittersweet ending has victory coming at a cost that is almost too much to bear. So what is the ending all about? And what is this high cost that Peter had to pay in order to achieve victory? So this is how you will frame your sentences in order to rouse the curiosity of the readers. Beyond its humor and nostalgia. So, what are the other elements in the movie? Humor, comedy, and nostalgia. There is humor, there is nostalgia. Every film has a message. Try to trace that message and mention it in your review. Trust me, this will make your review extra special. So, beyond its humor and nostalgia, there is a message that values redemption over revenge, reconciliation over rivalry. There are themes of love and friendship that are enriching the plot. Another word specifically related to films, the plot. The action scenes are riveting, attractive. Cinematography, special effects, background music, equally mind-blowing. Everyone has done a phenomenal job. The use of this word, phenomenal. Special words for writing a film review. However, Doctor Strange, perhaps, jumps into an incredibly dangerous spell without explaining the full consequences. What is so special about the use of the word, however? I have deliberately used the word, however. As discussed, no film is beyond criticism. Every film has flaws. So in a very polite way, you will have to point out one or two flaws. However, Dr. Strange perhaps jumps into an incredibly dangerous spell without explaining the full consequences. Peter too could have been more careful before approaching Dr. Strange. The lapses in the plot. Destroying the time-space continuum for anything that is not a world-ending threat is not an option he should have considered at all. And another observation, my point of view, J. Jonah Jameson, who always gives priority to hatred for Spider-Man, is ludicrous. He appears to be foolish in his hatred for Spider-Man. Now, the conclusion. The timeline of events is incredibly short. The film, especially 3D screenings, is highly recommended and must be watched on the big screen because of its grandeur. Notice the use of the term highly. You either highly recommend a film or you do not recommend a film. Use terms like blockbuster, superhit. This film is a blockbuster. This film is a super hit. Use words specifically related to films. I'm repeating this again and again. This will give your review a special flavor. And then, this film is to be watched on the big screen. This will give a positive vibe to the examiner or the reader. You are discouraging piracy and you are urging the readers to go to the theaters to watch the film on the big screen. And the reason? Because of its grandeur. My dear boys and girls, this is how you write a film review. In today's session, I have slightly exceeded the word limit and I have made use of approximately 300 words in order to finish my review. Take help from this video, watch the entire video and learn how to write a film review. The format provided by your school may be slightly different. Follow whatever is taught in school, but remember one thing, everything else remains the same. The introduction, the body, the conclusion and the tips for writing a superb film review.